I'm on the spot.
What is one interesting fact you've learned recently about the Active Board?
I know that the Active Board is a way to get students engaged further in a lesson without really too much time involved. I actually watched you at a presentation not too long ago, and I watched teachers who didn't know how to use the technology learn how to do it in less than 3 minutes. So if I could do this right now and throw this back to you, ask you a question, what do you think is the most beneficial thing, not just the Active Board, but also the other technology that we can use?
Well, to me, I'm a big advocate of students having a voice in the classroom, and I think that for many kids might be scared to speak up or scared to really voice their opinions, that the active expressions, the active voice of learning responses to really give them a way to participate without necessarily being embarrassed or scared. So to me, that is a really handy tool. And I also like that the Active Board encourages the students to come up to really be a part of the lesson.
You know what I noticed too, Laura, when you were doing your presentation, and also what I see happening out right now, is that it's not just clicking a letter or a number in anymore. You actually could ask text questions and get responses. Although I have to admit that teachers took a little bit longer to respond than students would. So you noticed that?
I did, and you know what? I attribute it to, we're used to texting, we're used to being on our phones, and teachers, maybe takes a little longer to get used to it.
Now, I asked you a question a while back, I think it's a really good question. I have some teachers that would love to use this technology. What do you suggest to them? Which of these types of technology would you recommend for teachers to start first with?
Well, I would say just to get in the door, firstly having the board. I mean, this is the pretty much essential thing that ties everything together. I would say that, an interactive whiteboard to me is a very handy thing because it really ties in multimedia, it ties in content, it ties in student participation. And so once you have an interactive whiteboard, that really gives you the chance to explore some of the other technologies as well.
Now, I know you've talked to other teachers. Have they told you, after using the whiteboard, that they wanted to get more technology?
Yes, I have talked to a lot of teachers. They've seen me present, or they've used an Active Board in their own classroom. They're like, it really opens up a lot of potential. There's a lot of wonderful things that we can do on the board that we want to start exploring.
Okay, I'm going to ask you the question I asked Mr. Cott. Where do you see this going in 3 or 5 years, when you'll be, what? You'll be 17, maybe?
By that point, I think that really there are no limits to what you can go and do. I think that the learning response systems will develop even further. I think the students will be able to participate in the classroom to even greater depths. So I think that it will really go above and beyond what it is at right now.
Wouldn't it be cool if you walk in the classroom? They're already a part of the classroom. Think about getting that.
That would be pretty awesome. You know what would be very cool would be if a classroom with the walls could just be interactive whiteboards all over.
I have a suspicion that her house may get that way pretty
quickly. Yes, it may.
This is Dora Spitak. She tried to interview me, but I tossed it back at her. And this is Ken Royal, Denver, Colorado, and we're at HD10 together. The old goat.